हाय गाइस, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल क्रैकबोर्ड 1920। इट्स अनु वर्मा। आज हम बात करेंगे चैप्टर सेकंड, दैट इज रिलेशन एंड फंक्शन, मिसलेनियस एक्सरसाइज। एक्चुअली आप सब सोचते हैं कि मिसलेनियस एक्सरसाइज है तो बहुत ज़्यादा टफ क्वेश्चंस होंगे, बट ऐसा कुछ नहीं है। आप वन बाय वन सब क्वेश्चंस देखिए, कितने इजी वे में आप आराम से इनको कर पाएंगे। सो स्टार्ट करते हैं। फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, एफ एक्स इक्वल्स टू एक्स स्क्वायर व्हेन एक्स लाइज बिटवीन 0 to 3 एंड 3x when x lies between 3 to 10. Again, gx, g is another function, x square when x lies between 0 to 2 and 3x when x lies between 2 to 10. Check karna hai, f and g are the functions or simply relation. Function ke case mein single element ki more than one images possible nahi hai. Same element keval ek hai, that is 3. In case of f and in case of g, single element जो same है दोनों conditions में, that is 2, ठीक है। तो first हम find करते हैं f 3 from first value, that means 3 square which is 9. Again f 3 is equals to 3 into 3, that means 9. 3 के corresponding केवल single image है, that is 9 in both cases. So f is a function, but when we calculate g 2, from here we will get 4 and from here we will get 3 into 2, that is 6. That means in case of G, single element 2 having more than one images, that is 4 and 6. So it is not a function, it is simple relation. Now second question is, if fx equals to x square, then find the value of f 1.1 minus f1 upon 1.1 minus 1. Since fx is x square, therefore f 1.1 is simply 1.1 square minus, what is f1? F1 is simply 1 square, that is 1 square. Now we apply a square minus b square. What is a square minus b square? A plus b into a minus b. So a minus b cancel out, this 1.1 plus 1, that is 2. Question number third is, find the domain of fx when fx equals to x square plus 2x plus 1 upon x square minus 8x plus 12. For finite values of fx, or when fx is defined, denominator is never 0. Okay, that means when we take any polynomial in denominator or any linear factors in denominator, then we take that value cannot be equals to 0. So fx is defined only when this term is non-zero. This implies factorize this polynomial by splitting the middle term. X square minus 6x minus 2x plus 12 is not equals to 0. Now x, taking common from first two terms, x minus 6 and minus 2 common, x minus 6. So we have two factors, x minus 6 and x minus 2. That means x is not equal to 6 and x is not equal to 2. So domain equals to complete set of real number minus 2 comma 6 in curly bracket. That means set. Next question is, find the domain and range of fx when fx is under root x minus 1. For domain, when we have fx in under root, square root, then for real values of fx, we take this term completely greater or equals to 0. That means simply we have x is greater or equals to 1. Therefore, what is domain? Domain is 1 to infinity. 1 in square bracket, infinity is always in small bracket. For range, first of all we assume y equals to fx. Substitute the value of fx, that is under root x minus 1. Now squaring both sides, y square equals to x minus 1. Then x equals to y square plus 1. Find x in terms of y. Since x is greater or equals to 1, we find x equals to y square plus 1. That means we have, combining these two terms, we have y square plus 1 is greater or equal to 1, or simply y square is greater or equal to 0. When y square is greater or equal to 0 implies y is also greater or equal to 0. So range is 0 to infinity, 0 in square bracket infinity small bracket. Okay. Now next one, find domain and range of fx where fx is mod x minus 1. For any modulus function, domain is always set of real number. We have to mention here that any modulus function is defined for all real values of x, that is sufficient, and then domain equals to complete set of real number. For range, any modulus function have always non-negative real numbers. That means modulus function is always greater or equal to 0. So fx is always greater or equals to 0. What is fx? Fx implies y is greater or equals to 0. And condition for y gives range. So range is 0 to infinity including 0. That means 0 in square bracket. Next question is, important question is, if f equals to x comma x square upon 1 plus x square. First of all, this ordered pair represent first value is x and second is fx. So indirectly we have fx equals to x square over 1 plus x square. X belongs to R. Find range. How can we find range? First of all, we substitute y equals to fx. Y equals to fx. Fx is x square over 1 plus x square. Now by cross multiplication, we have y plus x square into y equals to x square. Then transfer x square in same side. Y equals to x square minus x square y, or y equals to, taking x square as common factor, 1 minus y. This implies x equals to under root y upon 1 minus y. When we multiply divide by 1 minus y, we will get y 1 minus y over 1 minus y whole square. Since every square term is always positive, so first of all we exclude this term. That means 1 minus y is non-zero. Otherwise denominator becomes 0 and x is not defined. So y is not equals to 1. First condition. Then for real values of x, we take this term is positive. For positive, when we multiply two positive term, we will get positive, or when we multiply two negative terms, we will get positive. So either both are positive, but 1 minus y is not equals to 0, only greater than 0. And y is less than 0, 1 minus y is less than 0. There are two different conditions. First, when both are positive. Second one, when both are negative. Now first condition, when we solve this, we will get y is greater or equal to 0 and y is less than 1. That means range is 0 to 1, including 0 but excluding 1. Simultaneously, y is less than 0 and 1 minus y less than 0. From this condition, we have y is greater than 1. So this is impossible. Any value which is less than 0 and greater than 1. So this is empty set. That means range of this function is 0 to 1 only. Okay, now next is 7th question. F and g both are from R to R such that fx equals to x plus 1 and gx equals to 2x minus 3. Find f plus g, f minus g, f into g and f upon g. Simply f plus g into x equals to fx plus gx. कोई भी फंक्शन है, किसी भी पॉइंट पे आपने ऑपरेट करना है और उसको दोनों फंक्शंस के साथ वैल्यू अप्लाई करनी है. fx गिवन है x plus 1 और gx गिवन है 2x minus 3. That means we have 3x minus 2. In the same way, f minus g at x, fx minus gx. Substitute the value of f and g, that means 4 minus x. F into g, simply fx into gx, x plus 1 into 2x minus 3. That means 2x square minus x minus 3. F upon g at x, fx upon gx, x plus 1 upon 2x minus 1. Again, now next question is 8th question. F equals to, f is in the form of a set of ordered pairs. 1, 1, 2, 3, 0, minus 1, minus 1, minus 3 be a function from z to z. And fx equals to ax plus b. Find a and b. When any ordered pair belongs to F, this implies first value represent the value of X and second value represent the value of Fx. When 1, 1 belongs to F implies X equals to 1 and Fx is also 1. Now we substitute here the value of X as well as Fx. We will get A plus B equals to 1. Then 0 minus 1 also belongs to F implies X is 0 and Fx is minus 1. Now we apply here Fx is minus 1 and X is 0. So we have B equals to minus 1. Now substitute the value of B in this equation, we will get A equals to 2. So A is 2 and B is minus 1. Now minus next one is R is relation from N to N defined by R equals to AB such that AB belongs to N and A equals to B square. Then are the following true? We have to check these three conditions, these are true or false. First one is AA belongs to R for all A belongs to N. If AB belongs to R, this implies BA belongs to R. And if AB belongs to R, BC belongs to R, this implies AC belongs to R for all ABC belongs to N. First condition, AA belongs to R for all A belongs to N. This is impossible. Why? If we take 2, 2 belongs to R, that means 2 equals to 2 square. That means 4, which is impossible. So this is not true. Second condition, if AB belongs to R implies A equals to B square, then this does not implies B equals to A square because B equals to under root of A. So again, it is not true. That means if AB belongs to R, this does not implies BA belongs to R. Next one is, if AB belongs to R implies A equals to B square. If BC belongs to R implies B equals to C square. This does not imply that A equals to C square because A is equals to C4. When we substitute this value here, we will get C to the power 4. Therefore, AC does not belongs to R. So all three conditions are not true. Okay. Now next one is set A is 1, 2, 3, 4. Set B is 1, 5, 9, 11, 15, 16. And F is 1, 5, 2, 9, 3, 1, 4, 5, 2, 11. Are the following true? F is a function from A to B and F is a relation from A to B. Since F is a subset of product set of A product B. That means first elements is subset of A and second element subset of B. So F is subset of A product B. Therefore F is relation from A to B. This is true. But 2, 9 belongs to F as well as 2, 11 belongs to F. That means single element 2 having more than one images that are 9 and 11. So F is not a function. Next one is F equals to AB and A plus B. Here A product B and here A plus B. AB belongs to Z. Now check F is a function or not. Justify your answer. When we have justify your answer, we will give particular values of A and B. First we take A equals to 0, B equals to 1, then A, this becomes 0 and this becomes 1. So 0, 1 belongs to F. In second case, we substitute A equals to 2 but B equals to 0. Again we have this term becomes 0 and this term is 2. That means single element 0 having more than one images that are 1 and 2. So again F is not a function. Next, last one is A equals to 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 and given by F, N, the highest prime factor of N. First, we calculate F9. What is F9? Highest prime factor of 9 is 3. So, F9 is 3. Okay. Now, 10. Highest prime factor of 10 is 5. So, 10 ke corresponding image is 5. 11. Highest prime factor is 11. So, 11, 11 next element. 12 ke liye highest prime factor is 3 and 13 ke liye highest prime factor 13. So F is this. What is range of F? Range is 3, 5, 11 and 13. 3 ko repeat nahi karna hai. So ye thi aapki complete miscellaneous exercise second. I think simple hai. Koi problem nahi hai. If you have any problem, so give me any comment in comment section. So is video mein itna hi. अच्छी लगे तो लाइक माय वीडियो, शेयर इट विद योर फ्रेंड्स एंड डोंट फॉरगेट टू सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल. टिल देन बाय बाय.